Good morning, my dear students. We are back with our science period.
I hope everyone is ready for the science period. Are you ready?
Yes. Okay. In last video, we have started the new topic, that is lesson number 7, amazing animals.
Yes or no?
In that, we have discussed the two types of habitat. So, what is actually the habitat?
Habitat is nothing but the animal. Can live, the place where the animal can live, that is called as a habitat.
In the last video, we have discussed the two types where the animals can live, that is forest and desert.
The animals can also be found in the region, polar region and high mountains. Today we are going to discuss the animals which are found in the polar region and high mountains.
Polar region and the high mountain. The word itself says polar. If you might have heard the climate of the polar region, or if you might have visited the little bit high mountain, or you might have visited if the high mountain is nearby, it is Mahabaleshwar. You might have visited the Mahabaleshwar. How is the situation of the, can you just tell me how is the climate?
It is very cold, am I right?
But although the climate is very cold, we can see the different kinds of animals in such an area. We can get a different types of animals in polar region and the high mountains. For example, we can get in polar region, we can get polar bear, penguin. You might have heard these animals which we can found in the polar region. Am I right? So they have a special kind of, they have the special feature to protect from the cold. They have the thick fur on their body. Now in winter season, when it is cold, then what we are wearing sweater. The animals cannot wear the sweater, am I right? They don't have different types of clothes. So they have, according to the climate, they have a thick fur. The body is developed in such a way that they have the thick fur on the body. The body is totally covered with the thick fur. Are you getting this? So this is a special feature found in the animals, such as the animals which are living in the polar region and the high mountains. Are you getting this? The next habitat we found is in the ocean. Oceans. Now can you tell me ocean? If you will see in geography or in your SSC, you might have learned that if you consider the earth, you can see the more amount or the large amount of the earth is covered with the water. That is 3/4 part is covered with the water. That is oceans. Am I right? So the number of varieties of the fishes we find in this ocean. We can get a different number of different types of the animals in the ocean. Are you getting? So it's, which are the different types of ocean? So different animals which we can find in the ocean, that is blue whale, octopus, shark, this different kinds of the fishes are found in the ocean. Are you getting the number of varieties of the animals we found in the ocean? Then the next animal, next habitat we can see, the next habitat is that we get number of animals in the fresh water. If you will see the ocean water, it is little bit salty. Yes or no? It is salty. Can we drink that ocean water? No, because as it is salty, as it is saline, it is not good for our health. So we are drinking the mostly the fresh water. So in this fresh water also we can see the different types of animals, such as fish, salamanders, frogs. We get in the fresh water. Now, which are the fresh water? From where does we get the fresh water? From the river, lake, ponds, we get the fresh water. Are you getting this? So, these are the three types of habitat in today's video. I have taught you, that is polar region, high
high mountain, ocean and the fresh water. Now there are the different names which are given. Now the animals which are living on the land, they are called as a terrestrial animal. While the animals which lives in water, they are called as an aquatic animal. And the animals, those who live both on land as well as in the water, that is, for example, if you will take a frog, frog can live in water as well as on the land. So it is called as an amphibian. That animal is called as an amphibian. Are you getting this? I hope you have understood this. And related to this, there are the two MCQs which are given in your book. You have to solve it. Just I will go through that MCQs. See, the first MCQ, that is the surrounding in which the animal naturally lives, is called its habitat. Or the place where the animals can live, that is called its habitat. So tick to the habitat, everyone. Next, which of the following is an aquatic animal? Now, what is aquatic animals? The animals which can live in the water, that is called as an aquatic animal. For example, whale, penguin. Now, which is the animal which can found in the aquatic animal? Whale, penguin, or camel? Yes, whale. Whale is a fish which can found in the ocean, that is in the water. So, tick to the whale. The next one is adaptation in animals, that we will learn in the next video. So, read this today's habitat. Go through all this habitat, remove the difficult words, and write in your science notebook.